Hey friends, it's Joel Richardson, and I'm here in the ancient city of Dedan, the modern town or village in Saudi Arabia called al-Ula. We've been here for the past few days with about 25 on the first officially sanctioned Christian tour to Saudi Arabia in history. And all I can say is, not only has it been an amazing experience, it's been a tremendous honor, a tremendous blessing just to be here on the ground floor in the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia and what promises to be a place that is going to see, I believe, tens of thousands of Christian tourists over the next several years. What we've experienced here has been truly, truly nothing short of stunning. So first of all, we began up in the Tabuk province. This is the northwest province of Saudi Arabia, and we visited Jabal al-Lawz, which is the Mountain of Almonds. This is the mountain that many people, including myself, believe is the real biblical Mount Sinai. That experience alone is completely life-altering. To see some of the archaeological sites around the mountain, all I'll say is that the mountain sells itself. When you go there, when you see the altar of Moses next to the brook that comes down the mountain with the pillars next to the altar, and you look out from that vantage point, you look out and you can see the golden calf altar, it's as though if you were creating a movie set for the story of Mount Sinai, you couldn't create a better set. And it's just the degree to which it's been preserved. It's stunning. And we gathered together about 25. We held hands there at the base and we prayed and we sang a couple songs. And I really felt as though this was a profound moment in terms of the transition, the winds of change that are blowing across the Middle East and are blowing across Saudi Arabia right now. It was a planting of the stake in the spirit. It was almost as though we were saying, this is the mountain of God. The Saudi royals have now opened the country and welcomed us back in. And we're saying, Lord, we welcome you back in. Welcome home. And I really believe that there's a moment of transition here for the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, a God-ordained sovereign moment that we've seen a shift just in the spiritual atmosphere. Now, beyond Jabal al-Lawz, we've seen several other beautiful sites and locations. We're here now a couple hundred miles south. In the Bible, it talks about the caravan of the Dedanites and, you know, all these different biblical sites that are often forgotten because they've been behind this very restricted wall of Saudi Arabia. But more than just the ancient archaeological sites, more than the ancient historical sites, the biblical sites, I think the thing that is probably the most important thing is the people. The people that we've come in contact with just consistently from day one have been so welcoming. Just to see the smiles on their faces, the excitement. We were walking down the street and just random strangers would pull over and they would get so excited just to take a picture with us and say, welcome, welcome to Saudi Arabia. We stopped at this one stop and it was just a gas station that we were using the bathroom at this little mosque. And the owner of the gas station came out just beaming with a box of ice creams and just gave ice creams to everyone on the bus. And he was so excited to bless us and welcome us. And I think this is one of the most important things because we live in a moment in history where, I mean, at this moment where everyone is so divided, everyone is at everyone's throats. And a lot of it has to do with the shift in social media. We're relating to one another through this sort of inherently distant technology. But when you actually meet people, look them in the eye, talk to them face to face, get to know them, it changes everything. And you know, in the United States, you'll often hear people say things like, well, you know, I don't know the exact number, 17 of the 19 hijackers in 9/11 were from Saudi Arabia, and Saudi Arabia is the heart of radicalism. And look, ideologically, Saudi Arabia has birthed a lot of the radical movements, and there's definitely a radical element here. But the truth is, the overwhelming vast majority of the people here have been some of the most incredibly hospitable, welcoming, loving, wonderful treasures that I've encountered so far. You go to different Arab countries, and every country has a bit of a different atmosphere, a different culture, and what we've experienced here has been absolutely beautiful. I have a few passages in the Bible that I'm looking at that I truly believe indicate that there is going to be a mighty remnant of worshipers that are going to come out of this country. And so the tours here, it really, I'll say in the spirit, it's a holistic mission. We're coming to see the treasures, we're coming to experience all of these things, but in terms of the kingdom project that we're all involved in, there's something very important that's happening here. So it's been a tremendous honor just again to be here on the ground floor in this sort of just as the doors were opening, we came running through. We came in about 2 weeks after they officially opened visas for foreign visitors. And I really believe that this country promises to be one of the newest, most exciting, again, God-ordained places for Christians from all over the world to visit, to interact with the people, to experience the beauty is stunning. I mean, the mountains and the landscape is unbelievable. I mean, there's just so much to see here. So again, I look forward to potentially visiting with you sometime in the future here in Saudi Arabia. Until then, God bless and Maranatha.